To be able to commit and execute a given line in the backcountry or a specific move on a snowmobile, the rider must be confident in knowing what to expect from both his sled and himself. It will be impossible to commit to a task if you believe that it exceeds your abilities or the limits of the equipment you are riding. What are my limits and how do I find them? Expert riders are very aware of their limits. They know what to expect from themselves and from their sled. They typically ride at the edge of their limits and occasionally beyond. It is because they push the limit continually that they know what challenges can be executed and which ones might be a little bit sketchy. Hey folks, Brett Rasmussen here. I want to share some points with you on commitment. It doesn't matter what you're doing, without the confidence to try, being afraid of failure will stall your progression. You must try with confidence, knowing that you will improve with each repetition. Start by failing. If you never fail, that means you're not riding to your full potential. To become an advanced rider, you must take some amount of calculated risk. What are the consequences if I fail? And what is the reward if I succeed? When riders come to me asking what they need to do to improve their skill set, I often ask them how much they ride, because it generally comes down to time in the saddle. You need to be able to trust your sled. The only way you will be able to do that is by getting out on the mountain often and pushing yourself. When you know how your sled will react to bumps or ditch crossings, for example, then you can be prepared to respond to its reaction in advance. At Ride Rasmussen Style, we provide an environment to learn these things safely and have fun at the same time. Most of the time in the backcountry, we have so many variables. It is virtually impossible to calculate every situation and its outcome. The reality is that the more time you spend on your sled learning what to expect from it, the better prepared you will be to progress through the skills you want to learn. Another important factor in being able to commit to a new skill is progression. We teach how to ride a snowmobile in a linear progression, starting at the very beginning with rider position, then progressing to rolling up on edge, finding the balance points, and so on. I invite you to watch through the earlier videos if you haven't done so already. The point here is that in order to be able to do an advanced maneuver like a hopover, re-entry, or bow tie, you need to have the skill set that supports the basic principles and moves needed. In the bow tie, for example, you will need to know the rider positions, how to roll up on edge, have a solid understanding of the balance points. You will need good throttle and brake control. The knowledge and first-hand experience of how to ascend and descend the slope in control, and how to respond physically by looking ahead and thinking through the process in advance. Then perhaps one of the most helpful things when learning a new skill and being able to commit to it will be having someone there that can show you how it's done. This will help you visualize the task at hand. Hiring an instructor in this case will cut down the learning process dramatically and save a lot of headaches. We've been preaching all along, practice. Practice gives purpose to your experience. This will also reinforce your ability to commit and push through to the next level of riding. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and tell me about your experiences with this technique. Until next time, ride Rasmussen style.